Architecting your code with an effective structure plays an important role on what your app can support, how extendable it can be, how easily you can maintain it. Well, designing such a robust, testable, and maintainable app is what every developer aims for. In this course, we will look into a part of Android Jetpack, that is the Android architecture components. I'll give you a foundational knowledge of these components in order to implement it in your application with a well-structured architecture with minimum development effort. Hi everyone, I'm Annapurna Agrawal. I'm a full-stack developer and hold a great passion for Android. I specialize not only in Android, but also in the web development frameworks like Laravel. I like sharing what I know, and thus, here I am with this course. Keeping in mind the beginners, the course has been divided into sections, each comprising of multiple videos and quizzes. The topic we will be covering are as follows. In the section 1, I'll give you a brief introduction of what the Android architecture components are and why should you go for it. I'll also introduce you to Android Jetpack. Proceeding to the next section, in section 2, we will start with the first Android architecture component, that is the data binding. You will see how data binding easily lets us bind the data to the UI and how the related views can be updated easily. In the next section, section 3, we will jump to the next architecture component. I'll show you what are the lifecycle aware components, live data, and view model. Here you will learn how Android Jetpack has made it easy to implement the lifecycle aware actions. I'll show you how view model can help the data sustain the UI configuration changes, and then how live data makes it easy to update the UI automatically when the data changes. Interesting, isn't it? In section 4 and 5, we will move to the navigation architecture component and paging library. Here you will see how navigation is made easy with the use of this component. Passing data, the back and up functionality, all done without any boilerplate code. We will then move to the paging library, which we can use to load a large amount of data gradually and gracefully into the UI. In section 6, I'll tell you about one of the best local storage options, the room database. You'll see the magic of performing the database CRUD operations only by using the annotations without SQL queries. This is my personal favorite. The 7th section will be the next architecture component, which is the work manager. This is helpful for scheduling and managing the background tasks in a way that you might want to. Concluding the course, I'll give you the references to the sources for this architecture components. By the end of this course, you'll be mastering the implementation of these features in your Android app. To get the hands-on experience, in each of this section, we will have demo videos. The source code have been provided with each section. You can refer to it in case if you come across any issues. Now, is there any prerequisite? Of course, yes. You'll need to have a basic knowledge of Android application development and Kotlin. The goal of this course is to get you introduced to the Android architecture component, show you how it makes the development easy without any boilerplate code, and to give you a hands-on experience of using this component in your own app. Besides this, you need to be curious and full of enthusiasm to make the most out of this course. If you're ready, come and join me for this course on Android Jetpack, Android architecture components. See you in the course.